So, who wants to tell us what answer you want to explain and tell us how you did it, your strategy? Okay. Why don't you start? Okay, and how did you get it?
I put 26 on the top and 4 on the bottom. Oh. And then I times 6 times 4 equals 24.
Okay, yeah. And what did you do with that 24?
I put the 4 on the bottom of the 4 and the 2 on top of the 2. And 2 times 4 equals 8, and then plus 2 equals 10. Then I just put the 10 next to the 4.
Okay. Did anyone else do it that way? Okay, so remember this idea, you guys, pictures worth 1,000 words? Do we have a picture for that? Do we have a picture for that?
Yeah.
So someone, if you do, maybe I'll try your way. How would you draw a picture for that?
You do 26 circles and put 4 in each one.
Okay.
Or 4 circles and 26 rows.
Either one? Okay, instead of drawing lots of, since 4 circles is easier to draw, I might do that. Instead of drawing 26 dots, can I make a shortcut and put the number? Okay. And then this is pretty close to what we were doing down there, so if I wanted to make it like boxes and that are all the same, then I could put 26 in each one. Okay, another strategy. Who had a different strategy, not the stack and multiply strategy? What'd you do?
I have one for the drawing.
Oh, what was your drawing?
26 plus 26 equals,
So one person, are you defending the same answer?
Yeah.
Okay, so you used 26 and 26, and what'd you get?
I got 52.
No, it's not my answer.
And on the drawing, that might look like that.
On the bottom of the 52, I put another 52.
Where'd that 52 come from?
Because there's two ways. One you could do...
Oh, I...
Oh, 52 plus 52.
Do you want to finish your thought, or do you want someone else to finish your thought? Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, I put a 4 on bottom.
You put a 4 on bottom.
I added 2 plus 2.
Oh, you were adding. Sorry. I thought you just... Okay.
Added 2 plus 2 equals 4.
Uh-huh.
And 5 plus 5 equals 10, so 1. Yeah.
Okay. So, on the picture, could I also say that that equals 52?
Yeah.
And I'm going to call that... Can we call that double? You doubled 26?
Double.
And then doubled it again? The double-double? Okay. Is that a triple strategy? I don't know if that's the same. It's a double and a double. Okay. Did anyone break the number 26 apart?
No.
And do that? Or do you have a different way? Derek, what was your way?
I have a different way.
What's your way?
I looked, when I saw the number up there, I just looked at it.
Uh-huh.
And, but I didn't do it the right way. I did I know the 20 was in the tens place, so I did 20, 40, 60, 80, 4 times. And then, after that, I did the 6 4 times.
So how did you do this 6 4 times?
I counted by 6s all the way to 4. I did 6, 12, 18, 24, and then I added those 80 and 24 together. 80 and 24 together and made 104.
So that's 24 and that's 80 and all together 104. Whoa. Let's try that in a picture. And see, 20 plus 20 plus 20 plus 20. Hey, that's like our groups over here, our equal groups. I'm going to try drawing that. Here's 20, then 20 more, then 20 more, then 20 more. And how many did you get all together?
80.
80?
80.
20, 40, 60, 80. Okay, so that is... 80. And then he did the same thing with the 6. Where did this 20 and the 6 come from?
26.
Oh, I got it from the 26.
Oh, so wait a minute. I'm going to go right up here and say you started with this idea, 26. You did break it apart. Here's 20 and here's 6. So 26 is made up of a 20, two 10s, and 6 ones. So here's his, and we had to do what with it? Multiply by?
4.
4? Okay. So let's see. Here's our 4 20s. Here's maybe our 4 6s. And you said that's 24. Cool. And then 24, my getting kind of messy here. 80 and 24, you said all together is?
104.
104? Okay. Pretty cool, you guys.